Hey there, folks. This is Hand Shadow, and I decided to show you all a little tutorial about how to look at escape from Tarkov maps inside of Unity. This will let you fly through them in 3D and find really cool things about them. I started playing Escape from Tarkov about a week ago, a week and a half ago, maybe 2 weeks ago, I don't know, something like that. And I'm just not familiar with the maps. I get turned around a bit. And I thought it'd be really cool if I could just look at the maps inside of Unity. Escape from Tarkov is made in Unity, and I've been developing games in Unity for large studios for some time, since like beta, or not beta, but version 3. So what I did was I got this program called uTiny Ripper. And the uTiny Ripper allows you to open up or import assets from compiled Unity games. Escape from Tarkov installs like this, and it's got its executable here, but it's also got this data directory here. If you go into that data directory, after you've got your uTiny Ripper, you can drag one of these levels into it, and it'll take that. You can see there it's going to accept this file and it'll start importing. Takes a long time. Sometimes it could take hours. For this level 2 file, 10 megabytes here, it converted to be like 2.5, 2.3 gigabytes. So you need quite a bit of space to do this. I'm actually kind of scared because level 23 here has 91 gigabytes, and I'm thinking that's going to convert to be pretty big. Some of these other levels are pretty big as well, and they've got 165 levels. I lucked out and I decided there's no reason for me to do 12 kilobytes. I don't even know what it is. I could try it sometime. Actually, I'll just go ahead and do it right now. Let's just drag level 0 in here. And it's done. I don't know what this is. Let's go ahead and export it. This is the exact same way I did level 2. We'll just create a new folder here called Level Zero. There we go. And export the files. There are 101 files to be exported, and it's taking a long time for something. I don't know why. The fifth file has to be massive or something. Anyway, so you can see that this process, the export process, can take a long time just for just a small amount of files. It took me hours or maybe 2 hours for level 2. Once you have the files exported, and I've got them all exported here in EFT levels that I've done, I found out that level 4 does not seem to be used and level 7 does not seem to be used. It'll export out a bunch of stuff you don't need. You don't need text assets, you don't need fonts, you don't need animations, you don't need audio. A lot of that stuff you can just delete the files, delete the folders, and they'll go away. Once you've got your assets here, you're going to want to make a new Unity project. And it doesn't really matter where it goes, but I've put it here under Games in EFT. So there's my new project I've set up. You come over here to Assets, this folder is empty. What you will do, and what I'm going to do, so I'm going to select all these assets, press Control C to copy them, and then Control V in here to paste them. And it's going to paste in 2.25 gigabytes worth of data in here. And I'll go ahead and just let this run. I've got a pretty fast drive. Let it go pretty quickly. All right. There we go. Got a little bit of a files here now. When you open up Unity, if you've already got the project open, no idea why I tried to do that. All right, so now it's going to spend a few minutes importing all those files. So I'll go ahead and pause this while it does its work. Took a little bit longer than I thought it would take. Anyway, here are the assets. Nice, nice. We're going to go up here to the window, change the layout to 2x3, which I like. And I'm used to seeing this being a one column layout, so I'm going to change that. And I also like the console to be down here in the bottom right corner so I can quickly see errors. Much errors from importing the new project. We'll just clear those and ignore them because there's nothing critical with that. Another thing I want to do is grab my editor scripts and drag them into the assets as well. You don't have to do that because you don't have them. Now, editor should show up and it should compile. There we go. My scripts are in. All right, so now that we have all these guys in here, these, you can tell editor, material, mesh, physics material, prefab instance, scene, shader, shader variant collection, and texture 2D. Those are the main ones you'll want from level 2. The big one being scene, level 2. So we'll go ahead and double click that, and it should load. And that takes a while too. Okay, oh, lovely. We see a lot of lovely magenta stuff. And that is because the shaders were throwing a lot of errors. These shaders don't happen to be compatible. You can see parse error, syntax error, unexpected tval. I'll cut that. All right, so now that we have everything, we've opened up the level 2 scene. We will have materials up here, and there are a bunch of errors with the shaders. So I'm going to go ahead and open this up and select the first one on the list, then go all the way to the bottom. Hold down shift and left click and it'll select them all. And I'm going to change them all over to the standard shader. So now we have a nice dark area out here. There we go. There's one of the assets. If you highlight a bunch of them, you'll see, hey, the assets actually are showing up. All their associated textures with the objects that they should be. So, but this scene doesn't have a light. So what I'll just go do over here is I'll just put in a new game object, a light, directional light. And now you can see that level 2 is actually factory. And with it loaded, you can fly through it. A few errors here. That's fine. You get the idea that, hey, everything's really here and you can fly around in the map. There are a few things that you can fix. Like, let's look at this guy. This weird box here. It's called a puddle. And it's using this puddle, factory sharp. And these puddles are all opaque. So let's make them a cutout. Now your errors went away and you have cutouts. Same thing for if we go to the bathrooms. So I found the bathrooms. They're here and above them are some offices. And one of the offices has all of these papers on the floor. We'll go ahead and click this scattered paper. And it's using paper garbage 2 footsteps. You can click on that and change it to cut out as well, and it fixes all of the paper in the building. So all these papers are now fixed. So the cool thing about this is you can zoom out pretty far. You'll notice that there are a lot of hard shadows on the back sides of things. What you can do with that, I'll go ahead and close these guys down so we can actually see things in here. This guy can be closed down. We have a directional light. Press Control D on that to get another directional light. And all these hard shadows on this back side of objects, you can take this new one and rotate it by 180 degrees. So negative 30 plus 180 is 150 degrees. And now you have light on the back of objects. So you can see on either side of the objects clearly. And the reason why I'm doing all this is just to figure out how to get around in this map. But one of the cool things is you can zoom far out and take pictures of it. Let's go ahead and get this scene a little bit bigger on the screen. No, not there, not there. We want it to be big. Okay. Bam. All right, so then you can start taking screenshots and making maps for yourself and locating thing where things are in the map. But it's kind of hard to see the level if this stuff is in the way. So let's go ahead and with this scene file really big here, we will go ahead and turn off the roof. And then you get all this roof pieces underneath it. They're called firma. All these are actually grouped up nicely for us by Battlestate Games Studio. We'll go ahead and ungroup, turn that off. And now you're starting to be able to see a little bit better into the building. More roof is here. So we'll go ahead and turn that off. Now we're really starting to see into it. I don't really want those floating windows. And it's actually part of the entire walls and a lot of roofs. There's a lot of stuff grouped into this. And that's probably not a good way to do it in a project, but they did it. That's fine. We will go ahead and turn that off. So now you can really see the level. But there's a problem. Things are blinking on and off. We don't want that. If we zoom far out, we want to be able to take a picture that's a little bit more accurate, and we can turn the lighting up to light this up so it's not so dark when we zoom out, but we'll do that later. Right now, objects are popping in and out as we zoom in and out. That's called level of detail. And the reason for that is to make rendering faster for when you're down here. There's no reason to be rendering stuff that's really far away, that's like small until you get up close to it, right? So a lot of this stuff doesn't render at all. Ooh, there's some more errors here. Just click on that. Looks like some decal stuff. We'll just go ahead to this and make it cut out. All right, I fixed all that. There's probably another one right here. All right, cut out. And that fixed a lot of the building. Oh my gosh, it looks a lot better now. That looks really cool. So yeah, when you're zooming in and out like this, you don't want stuff to LOD in and out because you want to be able to take pictures far back with all the objects showing up. The really big ones to notice are these tanks right here. So as you zoom out, they pop in and they pop out. And that's fine for level design, but we don't want that for taking pictures, so we can figure out our way around this map. So I've written a script. This nice guy removes the LODs from Battlestate setup, and let me show you what that looks like. We'll open up Visual Studio, and what this is, and you can check this out, it's a really small script. So what I've done is I've made a Unity editor script. Even though it's a mono behavior, it'll still work fine because you're using a static void delete LOD groups thing through a menu item. And it'll create a new menu, EFT slash remove LOD groups, and it uses Control Alt L. Or maybe that's Control Shift L, can't remember. Because I wrote it a couple days ago. Anyway, so now we have this new EFT, and now we can remove LOD groups. So let's go ahead and zoom out a little bit so the tanks disappear. These are gone. And we will remove LOD groups from all the objects in the scene. There's right around 3200, 3400 LOD groups. Bam! Now the whole thing shows up. That black ball right there is actually in the lighting settings. You can come over here to rendering, lighting settings, and it's got this skybox night. That skybox was set to a standard shader. You can change that to a skybox. Bam. Okay, cube map. And it'll fix the problem. And now you no longer have that weird rendering issue behind. And now you can start taking pictures. And you can, if you want to do it in parts, you can. This is the spawn area. This is the first room. You could take pictures of this room however you want to do it. Hide these guys here if you wanted to. I'm control left clicking on all of them. And then I can come over here and just turn them off. And it looks like these didn't turn off. And then if you wanted to go even further, you can turn off the pipes that are hanging out above the room. Oops. Gotta make sure you click on the pipes and not between the pipes, or they will, you'll accidentally select the floor. There's some vents in here and stuff like that, but that's okay. I mean, if you want to get really detailed, you could turn those off too. Something looks wrong with this pillar, as if it had something turned off. Oh, it's a decal drip. All right. Well, it's a standard. Oh, standard cutout. Let's put that back to opaque. And what else? That's a vent, I guess. Let's see here. Decal dirt. Okay. Whatever. So now you can see all the pillars. Can take a picture of this and then use it, and then just go on to the next room, take a picture of that, and then mark your favorite locations to pick up loot and what kind of loot it is. You can zoom way out here, and it's pretty dark, but you can come down here to a directional light, and then you can change the intensity of the light to show the map a little bit better from this distance. And take a big picture of it, right? Like by zooming in on it. It gets a little bit too bright when you zoom in too far. But tweak it until you get it right. Like there's the exit, there's the entrance, there's a spawn. Let's go back to Unity. And turn down that light to about 20. And then still a little bit too bright, but that's fine. I mean, you get the idea. Put it at 10. I'm just having it's better. And there you go. Might be able to turn off that guy so you can see the interior. Turn off the concrete. Yep, there's the interior of the offices upstairs. Can't really see into the bathrooms, but that's fine. If you wanted to get rid of more of these beams, you could do that. Fine tune it however you want. But anyway, this is how you would go through and check out maps and escape from Tarkov. And you can fly through this and check out all your angles, good hiding spots, good ambush points, all that fun stuff. Anyway, thanks for watching the video and hope you enjoyed it. Bye.